What's going on, everyone? I wanted to tell you guys something that I'm very proud of, and that is we both drive pieces of crap. Now, if you see me driving down the street, I do drive in an Escalade. However,
don't come at us.
Don't come at us,
bro.
Because this Escalade is a 2004 Escalade, means it's older than most of your kids that are watching.
Okay? Pretty much.
2004 has over 100,000 miles on it, and we picked it up for $12,000. $12,000. Now, let me tell you why. We drive a piece of crap. What do you drive, by the way?
A Kia Sorento, which I love my Kia.
Which is beat to crap.
It's really bad. It has 164,000 miles on it.
Wow, I'm impressed that you actually know.
I do pay attention.
Wow,
sometimes.
I'm impressed because you don't remember where the gas gauge is, but you do remember how many miles there are. So here's something that's going to blow your mind when it comes to cars and how I truly believe that one of the biggest separators of wealth is new cars.
Absolutely.
And I'm not against new cars. If you have the money for new cars, buy new cars and enjoy it. I just want people to understand the opportunity cost of having a new car.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I was doing some research here, and there's a link that we're going to put in this below this video or above this video or wherever it might be about how we save for these cars, how we pay cash for these cars. But here's some of the shock factors of these cars. Okay. So the average car payment right now in North America is $523 a month. That is the average car payment. Over about 5 years, so 60 months, okay? Mm-hmm. The average price of a new car in 2018, so this is numbers that always lag a year, was $34,000. Okay, so people, on average, it could be lower, it could be higher, but on average, they're driving around in a $34,000 new car,
mm-hmm.
and the car payment's $563 per month.
Yikes.
Now, here's where it gets a little tricky, is that's what we see when we go, you know, leave the dealership, when we sign the dotted line. We think we're driving away and we're paying $563, but it is much more than that. And I'm gonna show you how this works. So a new car, if you look at over the past, am I talking too much?
No, you're good.
If you look at over the past years and years and years and years, we can get pretty good data on how much a new car will sell for if we buy it brand new and then we sell it in a couple years. So on average, your car loses 60 to 70% in the first 4 years. In the first hour, meaning by the time you go from the car dealership to your house, it loses 11%. So let's think about this. $34,000 car goes down by 11%. Let's just make it easy, 10%. By the time you get it in your driveway, it's gone down in value $3,400. I know people who freak out about losing $100 in their 401k. You just lost $3,400 by the time you got home. It gets worse.
It's like taking that money and just being like, here you go, out the window, out the sunroof, just throw it out the window, right?
Absolutely. So it gets worse though, because in the course of about 3 to 4 years, we'd say 60 to 70%. So I just did some math. I just said, let's say 65%. Let's meet in the middle. So if your car goes down 65% and on average you buy it for $34,000, that means 4 years later, you could sell it for $12,000, okay? Which is a $22,000 depreciation. It means it went down $22,000. Mm-hmm. Who's paying for that? You are, or whoever's buying new cars. So you know what that tax on each month, if you just divide it out monthly, you know, over 60 months, that's $366 a month. Now, you might want to go check my math. It might be 364, but it's really freaking close. So really, the average car payment in America is $563,
mm-hmm.
okay? But then the depreciation, someone's paying for that car going down in value, and I guarantee the dealership ain't paying for it. You are, right? It goes down $363 a month. We're close to a $900 car payment. But then also, if you have a new car and it's more expensive, your insurance is higher,
mm-hmm.
your tags are higher. So yeah, we're looking at $1,000, maybe $1,300 a month in this car.
Mm-hmm.
When we started doing the math on that, because we were new car people, she had a BMW, I had a brand new truck.
We were absolutely always new car people because we had to keep up with everybody and everybody else mm-hmm. had a new car and we were making money. So we thought we had to spend it like we were making more than we actually were.
Yeah,
like,
we thought we were rock stars.
We were like
America. No, we weren't. We were just pretending to be.
Yeah.
So when I started looking at it, I just said, let's round up, you know, a number. And when I said, this car is costing us $1,000 a month for 5 years, and then we recycle the process, mm-hmm. what if we could make this way less painful? So we started looking at, what if instead of spending $1,000 a month, because technically that's what we're spending, although it doesn't feel like it, if you do the math, that's exactly what's happening. Math doesn't lie. If you're spending $1,000 a month, what if instead of spending $1,000 a month, what if we made a car payment to ourselves for maybe, I don't know, $200 to $300 a month,
mm-hmm.
and every 4 to 5 years, we buy a car for cash?
And
a piece of crap car for cash.
But it's newer to us, an older car, but I always say our old new cars.
Yeah.
Because they're new to us, right? Mm-hmm. So it feels nice. But somebody already lost the value on that car, right? Let them do it. And then you reap the benefit of finding a decent car for way less that you just paid cash for.
And another thing we do is instead of, you know, that there's that $700 difference. Let's say we make a $300 car payment to ourselves, which we do every month. And we'll tell you how to do that. So if the average person's paying out about $1,000, you know, on average, we just did the math on that, then really there's a $700 difference. Where's that $700 difference going? It was going towards debt. And once we got rid of debt, it was going towards building wealth.
Yes.
And do that for 10 years. You know what? We should put a link to a financial calculator. No, that's boring. We'll do that a different time. We're not doing that. But what I wanted to say here is, how should you be saving for this? Should you be putting in the envelope? No, don't do that, because this is $300 every month, right?
Well, and it's easy to get to if it's in an envelope in your house and something that sounds fun or exciting to buy comes up. You're going to go searching for that envelope that's probably not well hidden in your house. So it's better to put it away.
Out of sight, out of mind,
harder
too.
Harder to get to harder until to you to. Absolutely
still your money, but it's
because you're not going to need it for several years, because obviously you're not going to keep buying new, you know, new older cars all that often.
So here's what we do is we open up these things called sinking funds. There's a link in this video talks about how a sinking fund works, but really it's just a really cool name for online piggy banks.
That's
it's
what I was gonna
not
say.
Not a bank here locally, it's a bank that's online. It's a regular bank, you're insured up to $250,000, so it's just like a normal bank, but you don't to get to the bank, you have to go online and actually grab the money online and have it sent to you. So the nice thing about having a sinking fund is you can save for things like Christmas and things like new cars to us, right? Which is, I know, for.
All of the things that you would want to save throughout the year, you can automatically set it up to put a certain amount. You get to decide. It's your money, your life, however much you want for Christmas or how much you want for the old new car.
Yep.
Then you set it up to automatically transfer into that account. And then when it's time to use it, it's available to use. How easy is that, right?
So in the post, we just updated this morning. I was going through it. We put a link to CIT Bank right now. CIT Bank has the best returns. So like most of the big banks around Phoenix, or it's a relive, but around wherever you're at watching this, they're terrible. You're not getting any return at all, right? It's like next, it's like pennies, you know, where CIT Bank's about 22 to 30 times higher. It's all online, there's no branches, that's why they can pass the savings on to you, so check that out. But also, don't just create a sinking fund for your new car, which is your piece of crap car eventually, but create them for, you know, vacations or anything big you wanna save for. It's way easier when you save a little bit into each little sinking fund every month. So we do like 60 or 70 bucks into the Christmas fund every 2 weeks. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden at the end of the year, we're like, holy crap, we have over $1,000.
And it's what's most important to you. If you want a lot of money to vacation, then obviously you're going to allocate a lot of money towards vacation every month, however big that goal is. But that's the neat thing is you get to decide. And then come Christmas or come a vacation, it's not going to be like, oh, crap.
We have a friend that's saving for a boob job in a sinky fund.
And
you can nickname these funds. You can name them.
You can say
like boob job fund. We call it a new car fund. Whatever you want to do. I think it's awesome.
But I think just going back to the car thing, we are not Captain No Fun and co-Captain No Fun.
I drive an Escalator. Are you kidding me? I'm Captain Awesome.
We're not saying that you can do whatever you want. But here's the thing. A lot of people in America, they live with debt. And a lot of people think, I'm always going to have a house payment and I'm always going to have a car payment. Sure you are. If you keep doing what you're doing now and you keep going out and buying cars that we can't afford. And I can say this because guess what? We were the people doing that. So I'm talking about myself. I'm not pointing fingers. But if you want to live a life really on your terms without spending money by giving it to somebody else that you leased or you bought a car from that you didn't pay cash for, and become the slave to that, then you have to start doing things differently. And some of that means you have to sacrifice driving the fancy car for a little while until you can actually afford it. There are plenty of people out there that drive a fancy car and they actually can't afford it. There are plenty of people, a lot of people that drive them that can't. And so we just didn't want to be like that anymore because, like you always say, normal is
70% of people are living paycheck to paycheck, right?
$15,000
in credit card debt.
Let's not be normal anymore. Let's do something different.
Yeah.
Let's stop it now and start working towards how we really want to live. And I'm telling you, a car is just a car. It doesn't mean anything. It doesn't make you worth more. It doesn't make you better than somebody. In fact, I roll in my Kia thinking,
she's dominating.
You know what? Oh, I don't pay for this anymore.
I'll share
and
some of the top 10
the money
10
that
facts.
I would pay for that goes into retirement. So one day we can retire and go live in
We're
going
to drive
somewhere.
A car that flies one day. I promise
Maybe.
You that much. Here's some
Maybe.
Of the cool things about driving a piece of crap car. You can park it anywhere in the parking lot and you don't care if somebody dings it because mm-hmm. it's a piece of crap car. If you have kids that trash the inside, you don't get as upset.
No.
Right?
No.
You don't feel as bad about not getting car washes because it's like polishing a turd sometimes. Right?
I mean, how good can you make it look?
You don't pay for valet parking because you're not going to pull up to that in a valet parking, right? So
you
get exercise for parking further away. There's
actually,
so many benefits. And insurance is way less, which is huge.
Is
in Arizona,
registration.
Our registration is huge. And when it goes
expensive.
By the value of your car. So, and here's what's cool about buying a piece of crap cars. We bought a $12,000 Escalade.
Mm-hmm.
We bought this $12,000 Escalade. We're going to drive it for 2 or 3 years. And we're going to sell it for $11,000. So the depreciation is going to be about $1,000 versus paying $22,000 on average.
And the car you bought, you had before that you sold in order to buy the $12,000 mm-hmm. Escalade, you sold for...
We bought a $12,000 Denali, and we sold it for $10,000.
So,
and that
see,
was a four-year
The loss
four-year
on
track.
That, real small. Yeah. Remember, I'm not good at math, but the numbers, they mm-hmm. don't lie, like you said. And I can actually look at that and be like, okay, that's a good deal. I can see the difference.
To her, numbers equal vacations to Europe.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. You don't have to love numbers. You don't have to be great at math to win with your money. And I am actually here to tell you that because you all know, because I'm not good at math. And I feel like I'm doing pretty good. Obviously, I have this guy guiding me, leading the way. But that's why he's here to help you too, because you don't have to do it the old way. You can do mm-hmm. it differently, and you can do it different than all your friends, because one day you're going to be retired.
And you're going to be
a lot of money, and you're going to have houses that are paid for, and you could drive whatever car you want. And then that's a big fist bump to retirement.
Mm-hmm. All right. So that's
living good life.
That's living
right
good
there.
Life. So drive a piece of crap now. It's not a big deal. You have so many benefits. You save so much money. You can get out of debt quicker. You can build wealth a lot faster.
You can say yes to the things that matter.
Yeah, and then when your kids are grown up and they're not living at home and trashing the crap out of your vehicles, then go buy a nice car.
And you don't have cars.
Because I meet so many people that are like, my kids just trash it. I'm like, then why would you buy a nice car?
Yeah.
You know? All right.
Okay.
But for those of you who do have nice cars and you love your cars,
that's
fine. We are so happy for you.
Yeah.
And I'm not trying to pick on anybody here.
Don't come at me.
Don't come at us. Yeah. Okay.
Don't come at us, bro.
Yeah. And in fact, if you do have a nice car, come pick us up.
Take us somewhere.
Right? Take us somewhere.
And let's valet your bad boy. I'll pay for the valet if you pick us up in it.
All right. Sound good?
Bye.